so that there was something that makes us talk about.
Yes, okay, that's a good idea. Yes. Okay, so we need to set a date for that amendment. We'll take the one that you vote on constitutional. We'll move ahead. We should get this one.
If there is on this list, there's an additional one.
Yes. Well, I have queried that because I've not been made aware of that. I don't know how it's come to be on the list. It's not come through committee. If somebody wants to put it on the work programme list, I'm happy for that, but it didn't come through me.
I'm just going to go on the list.
I don't know if
it's been. There was results. It's very late.
Limits are, Chair, to the allowances
say that process before this works for council. So, for example, absolute upper limits or those kind of elements. You know, well, these are going to prove due to.
Well, again, we need some sort of reports as a basis for us to work on. And Phil, again, you've been very patient.
Mr. McCorkle, know a little bit about this one, but he was the present arrangement when the mayor received motions as the mayor meets with Mr. McCorkle and predecessors to discuss what might be debated at council and what might be moved elsewhere. There appears to be some email the last day or so suggesting that myself and Councillor Lewis might be invited into that setting to discuss these things. But I'm not sure the constitutional arrangements are for that. Might go into those settings and have a sort of general friendly conversation about which one we're doing, which one we're ordering, what we think the mayor should do. But I'm not sure what the constitutional basis of it was. Is what the sort of parameters will be, which the soft power of chatting to officers and the mayor might be used.
If I may, Chair, the process is set here because this is the committee that recommends changes to constitution. So, in terms of the hard rules, as it were, the hard rules are that it's the chair's discretion as to what happens to the notices of motion. Are they referred elsewhere? Are they heard by council? In what order? All of those questions are commonly dealt with by the mayor and subject to the mayor's decision. In terms of there always being more notices of motion than there is time to debate it. The suggestion is that when the mayor makes that decision, she does so in the presence of group leaders or the nominees. Because they can provide helpful advice in that process. That's an invitation, as I understand it, to themselves, to join them in that process. It doesn't change the constitutional rules. The decision is still the mayor's, but she is taking the step to invite you to join.
I don't think that needs to be.
So it doesn't need to go through the
agenda. Okay, so we'll try and get some dates in the diary to start the first piece of work and then we'll try and move through this. Okay, thank you very much everybody.